2014 was the hottest year since we started tracking weather patterns in 1880. In fact, all the hottest years in the top 10 have been since 1998, and 2015 is heating up too. Hey everyone, thank you for watching DNews Today. I'm Trace. A heat wave is gripping southeastern India and has, as of this taping, killed more than 2,200 people, mostly in the states of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. Temperatures have topped 120 degrees, melting roadways in the populous Asian nation. Like the western United States, part of India are also in a drought. And this being an El Nino year, the country is likely to experience a large number of typhoons and super typhoons, which are the same as hurricanes or cyclones, but less monsoon rain. If all this sounds bad, it's because it is bad. But India is no stranger to heat waves. In 2003 and again in 2010, around 3,000 people died from heat waves in Andhra Pradesh alone. The Farmers Almanac, that bastion of weather knowledge, says that heat waves are prolonged periods of heat caused by high atmospheric pressure impacting an area. When a high pressure system pulls air from the upper atmosphere toward the ground, that air compresses and heats up, holding other weather systems at bay and settling over a wide area. These high pressure systems can block cloud cover and inhibit winds, meaning the sun's heat compounds the already warm, dense, stagnant conditions. Doesn't sound very pleasant. Under normal circumstances, we are incredible at cooling our bodies. Maybe some of the best animals on the planet at it, actually. But in extreme temperatures, humans simply can't handle the heat. Part of the problem in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana is the humidity is very high on average. Sweat evaporates far more slowly in high humidity. No evaporation, no cooling. So the body then sweats more, causing dehydration. When the body can't dissipate its heat, fainting, cramps, heat exhaustion, or heat stroke can result. These afflictions affect the elderly, the sick, the young, and those in urban areas more prominently, but could affect anyone. Essentially, the heat overwhelms the body's ability to cool itself. Eventually, we stop sweating altogether, and that is the red alert. Heat can cause muscle cramps or fainting due to electrolyte shortages lost during sweating. Obviously, you'll get thirsty as your body tries to get you to replenish lost water, but as your brain becomes affected, symptoms include dizziness, weakness, and becoming uncoordinated and nauseated. That's when you know it has hit the brain. As water loss peaks, the blood becomes thicker, the heart can't pump it as well, the kidneys can't clean it as well, and the oxygen levels in your blood drop. In response, the heart tries to pump more blood, faster, at an increasing rate, which heats up the body, causing a feedback loop, which causes cold, clammy skin, and eventually, death. Once thermoregulation fails, it's pretty much a spiral into terribleness, which is why it's so important for animals, like us, to stay cool. Anything over 104 for humans is pretty bad, and that goes for fevers, too. Weather patterns like heat waves occur naturally, although they can be exacerbated by humans. For example, asphalt and concrete store heat all day and then release it at night, keeping the environment from naturally cooling. This is called the urban heat island effect. Additionally, global climate change or global warming is also a culprit. In a 2014 bulletin of the American Meteorological Society, 20 teams looked at 16 events from 2013 and found human activity greatly increased the risk for the extreme heat waves. And separately, 5 studies of Australia's 2013 heat waves found the chances of observing such extreme temperature in a world without human-caused climate change is almost impossible. Seemingly singular problems like sea ice melt causes more solar heat absorption by that darker water, accelerating climate shifts as well, causing more heat waves and possibly more deaths. When the heat is on, make sure you stay in the shade, cool off, and allow your sweat to evaporate. Stay cool, folks. These heat waves are deadly, but which one was the worst ever in history? Seeker looked at that deadliest one, and it wasn't that long ago.
That distinction belongs to the European heat wave of 2003, an event which claimed the lives of over 70,000 people across the continent.
Plus, for the full story, make sure that you watch Test Tube News because they dug into all the climate research and reveal the hottest countries around the world.
These nations contain significant expanses of arid, hot desert.
Thanks for watching DNews. Please subscribe, and we will see you next time.